How did I end up here? And how am I going to get out? Am I going to stay here forever? Help! Please help! Hey puzzle lovers, welcome to the Luban Log puzzle series. My name is Michael and today we are going to attempt to solve a new wooden puzzle. This one looks very interesting. It has the shape of a cage and it's made of so many wooden pieces. It's so crazy. I'm really excited to try to solve it. So let's jump in. And here is our nice wooden puzzle. The name of it is the cage. And really, it looks so interesting. I mean, look at it. So it's made of 12 wooden pieces that are all connected to each other. Well, all. They're connected 3x3 to each other. And that's very interesting because I'm sure it will be a challenging puzzle. And that's very nice. So let's just try to solve it. First, what you can notice is that there is some pieces that are really like stuck. You cannot turn them. You can move it because of the movement of all the puzzle. So this four here cannot move, this four here cannot move as well, nothing, but this four here can rotate it on themselves. Well, just a bit. So I suppose the way to go with this puzzle is to try to rotate them, these four, to kind of unlock the other pieces. So we will try it. I think you will need to force a bit, maybe not too much to not break the wooden puzzle, of course, but I think it's the way to go in. So now, let's just try. I don't know, because it's really like the only clue that I have about this puzzle is that you can move some of them. So I don't really want to break the puzzle, but I think there should be a room to open it. Okay, so this one, I could rotate it. So maybe there will be some that you need to do first. And then you see that you can, you kind of unlock this one. So if you do the same on the other side. Kind of hard because you can move some. Okay, so maybe you need to move it like this. So you can give the whole opening to this one, to this piece to get out. And I'm sure you need to do the same on the other side. Now it's a bit hard. Maybe there is a like specific way to rotate them. I don't know. Okay, yeah. So I rotate once again. Yes. So now I need one more. Okay, so now I can remove my first piece, and that's very nice. That's this one. Okay, so we have one piece, and I think we need to do that with also the bottom ones. And maybe you can also, yeah, you can remove the other side. That's very interesting. That would be a bit a nightmare to solve because you need to remember that there will be one piece that you need to put from the inside. And then another piece that you need to put on the outside. And also you need to remember where do we go. So that's the opening that we wanted to see from here. Now we can also remove the two inside. That's interesting. Okay, so that will be really a nightmare because they don't look alike. So that's interesting also. Now we just need to do the same on the two bottom. And we should be good to disassemble all of this wooden puzzle. It's really a bit hard. It's quite a tight fit. Okay, so we have this one. And then with this one, we can remove this. We can remove this one. And then we just need to rotate this one now. I can just actually rotate it like this. Okay. So then I can remove this one. And I can rotate this one like if it wants to turn. Okay, and so now we have all our pieces disassembled. Like the cage has been opened, and that's very nice.
Time to escape. No way I'm staying here. Finally, the liberty is mine!
Let's try to get a close look now to this puzzle, because I believe there will be some pieces that they will be similar and other ones that will not be similar. For example, so this one are different. This one are the same but mirrored. Well, if you move it like this, then they are the same. This one is the same as well, so you have three like this, four like this. I'm sure you will have other ones. Yeah, this one too, this one no, this one, and this one. So you have these eight pieces that are the same. So I think that's the ones who don't move at the beginning, and the ones that get rotate, you see, they have different shapes from the eight other ones, and they have like kind of a big cut around to give the space to rotate that the other ones don't have. So on the middle they will look alike, but then here they will not. They will have this extra cut to kind of give this extra room for this piece to move, to rotate, and to give you the key to unlock the cage. That's very nice! Now the challenge will be to put it back together. I went a bit fast at the end, and that might be a mistake, but it will be fun to reassemble, I'm sure, now that we know that there is two kinds of pieces. We know that these ones will go 2x2 with one like this until we remake the cage, and the challenge will be to make sure that sometimes we put these ones, we will call them the key, we put them from inside to lock the puzzle from the inside, and then sometimes it will be from the outside. So let's just start. So we take two like this. So now what we need to do is to remember how to put them together, because then you have this one that needs to rotate from here. So this one will go here, and it needs to lock one like this. So you have one like this, maybe? No. That would be the challenge. How was it? So to solve it, we need to remember that this one needed to move to give this kind of space for this one to be removed, like this. So it was, yeah, like this exactly. So we need now to make sure that we have this kind of opening. So that means that we need also to do this movement again. So we need to give a space like this for this one to slide, and then we need to put this third piece and then kind of lock it again like this. So now from that, we need to think about how. So I think this one would be like this, maybe. So we have these two, and then this one needs to rotate to be locking everything. See, yeah. Yeah, so here we have our first corner. That's very nice. That's very nice. So maybe we also need to do the other one at the same time, so we don't lose anything. So we take two other pieces like this, and we do the exact same position on the other side. So we need one that will be like this, because we need to remember that we need to have this big cut from the outside. It's how we manage to remove puzzle. So it was this, and then we have one, I think it will be like this, I guess. So we need to be careful about everything. So this one gets inside like this. So we have this outside. And then this opening goes here, like this, here, and then we need that to be and then we need that to be on the other side, so everything is mirrored. Now this one needs to get here. So this one here. Then we need to put this one. So maybe this one first, actually. This one first. This and then this one from the inside will be like this. To lock it. Now that doesn't make sense. This one like this and this one like this. Here, so now that we have our two sides here, we can rotate this one to lock both corners. Yeah, so we just rotate one and we have two corners. That's very nice. This puzzle is really smart because you have this kind of keys and then you have the other pieces that you just need to mirror from each other on each corner, and then with one key you lock two corners. Really, that's very clever puzzle actually. Okay, so let's just forget, I put this one here, and now I just need to rotate this one, just one, and then this one also just one. Okay, so finally, I just put it back to its original position, and here we have our wooden cage back to its original shape. Really nice, really beautiful puzzle, and this one has been solved. And another puzzle. Wow, this one was very nice. Really, the cage wooden puzzle is such a very interesting puzzle. Why? Because you have this kind of four pieces that act as keys and you have to turn them to kind of liberate the other pieces. Very nice, very smart idea. I really enjoyed solving it. Really, it's one of the best wooden puzzles I solved so far. I hope you did enjoy watching this video, but you do enjoy this Luban lock puzzle series. Subscribe to the channel if you didn't do it yet. It will help me and support me to continue to make this kind of video. I see you next week to solve another puzzle. Tschüss!